believe that the twins are almost here.
I just hope that you don't go into labor on the day of the wedding, Jean.
I hope so, too.
I can't wait to see Nevaeh and Sean, Jean.
Same here.
Not long now till Diddy and Dixie are married. They're getting married in a few weeks, Seanick. I know, and at least Jean isn't changing into a werehog while pregnant.
Seanick, please don't remind me.
Shall we? And let's hope, following the wedding, a group of superheroes don't get sued for doing stupid shit.
Really, Seanick? I'll get it.
No, Jean, you're gonna stay seated. We don't want you to hurt the twins. Besides, I just built you a wheelchair made out of recycled aluminum can parts.
I know that you're my doctor, Seanick, but I want to walk around, please.
The cans I used for this wheelchair is from all those times you drank Dr. Pepper.
I can't drink Dr. Pepper while I'm pregnant, Seanick.
Actually, I lied. Me and Sonic drank a lot of sodas, and we got so hyper from the caffeine and the sugar that we nearly trashed my lab. Don't strain yourself, Jean. And yes, Seanick, those sodas were tasty. But after that, I had to run laps around the town to burn all those calories we consumed from all those sodas.
Wow.
Diddy, can you get the door, please?
Aye, sir!
Are you referencing Happy from Fairy Tail?
Yeah, it's an amazing anime!
Trust me, it is.
I thought he was referring to Aye-Aye from Super Monkey Ball.
Sonic, don't refer to me as Aye-Aye, please!
Sorry, Abu.
Oh my You're demoted, Sonic.
One of these days, that meme is gonna get old fast.
It'll never get old. Besides, Laurel loves to demote David, especially after watching that scene from Star Wars The Last Jedi, where Leia slaps Poe. Hey, Luigi, what's up?
Not that much, Daddy. I brought over a puppy's eat muffin for a Jean.
Thanks, Luigi.
Jean, stay seated!
Jeez, really, guys?
Dr. Pepper wheelchair!
Don't tease me like that, Seanick!
I'm not, I was just thirsty. Looks like you've been playing Luigi's Mansion, Jean.
It's a great game.
I remember that game. It was the first game that featured me as the lead role.
What about Mario is Missing?
No, not that game!
That game was just terrible, and it doesn't even count as my first game.
By the way, where is Mario right now?
He had a date with Princess Peach. He was going to take on a ride on the Odyssey, and see a lot of kingdoms he visited, while I merely played a balloon game with him.
It sounds like Mario is showing Peach a whole new world.
You're lucky I wasn't wearing a cap, Eugene!
Hey, Jean, wanna review Luigi's Mansion?
Well, since I only reviewed two Mario games on my channel, I don't see why not on reviewing another one.
Can I join you guys on reviewing this game?
Sure, Luigi.
Anyway, let's get started. And don't forget to check out our past reviews of Super Mario 64, Super Mario Galaxy, Donkey Kong 64, and Donkey Kong Country 2 Diddy's Conquest. Click on the Zelda protagonist below.
And we still need to try to plan our reviews for Super Mario Galaxy 2, Ocarina of Time, and maybe Sonic Lost World.
Are you sure you want to review Sonic Lost World, Jean? It might trigger Sonic's PTSD.
You've got a point. How about Sonic Unleashed?
You can review Sonic Lost World if you want to. My PTSD is doing alright now.
Okay, if you say so. And if I had a Switch, I would also want to review Super Mario Odyssey.
What about 3D World?
Huh? I never thought of that before. 3D World could be a possibility.
Well, I know one way to start out with this. Have you ever wondered how a new game system would have a launch title starring Luigi and not Mario? That's what Nintendo did with the GameCube with Luigi's Mansion. Nintendo wanted to do something different since Mario had launch titles for the NES, SNES, and the Nintendo 64. So it was fair that Luigi gets a turn to be the star.
Well, here's a little fun fact that nobody knew. Did you guys know that Luigi's Mansion wasn't originally going to be the launch title for the GameCube? It was originally going to be Donkey Kong Racing. But due to Rare being bought by Microsoft, Donkey Kong Racing was canceled, and now the launch title for the GameCube is Luigi's Mansion.
Wasn't Super Smash Bros. Melee also a launch title for the GameCube?
Actually, Sonic, Melee wasn't released until a month after Luigi's Mansion.
12 years later, we got the sequel called Luigi's Mansion Dark Moon on the 3DS. And the original Luigi's Mansion is going to be getting a remake on the 3DS very soon. And the next year, we're going to be getting Luigi's Mansion 3 on the Nintendo Switch.
Maybe sometime in the future, we can also review Luigi's Mansion Dark Moon. And whenever I get a Switch, right around the time next year when Luigi's Mansion 3 comes out, we can review Luigi's Mansion 3 as well.
Great idea, Gene. Goodness gracious, are you feeling alright?
Yeah, I'm fine, Sonic. Just the twins are kicking, that's all.
The game begins with me winning a mansion in a contest that I didn't enter. I promptly told Mario about the mansion, and we agreed to meet up outside it that day evening. What kind of contest was it? A costume contest where Silver used psychokinesis on Shadow's bathrobe? No! Don't remind me of that, Sonic! So anyway, I took a flashlight and followed the map to the mansion. Upon finally arriving at my new mansion, which looks much more sinister than the supplied photo, Mario is nowhere to be found. I proceed inside the mansion, entering the parlor after I got the key from a strange ghost-like shape. Too bad I didn't use those keys to win James a Halliday's Easter egg in the Oasis. Upon entry, I'm so scared by a gold ghost, only to be saved by a little old man wielding a vacuum cleaner.
Oh!
Ghost! Hide me, Gene! That wasn't very nice, Didi!
Sally Luigi!
So anyway, the old man, however, is unable to reel in the ghost and is soon overpowered. After being helped to his feet by me, the old man introduces himself as Professor Elvin Egad, or Professor Egad for short. Because of the interjection, Egad! We soon retreated from the mansion when more of the gold ghosts appear. In Egad's laboratory, he explains how Luigi's newly won mansion is obviously the work of something not of this world, as it only appeared a few nights ago. As Luigi further explores the mansion, he discovers that it was built by King Boo, the King of the Boos. Oh, I thought he was the King of the Britons.
That was clever, Sonic!
It's called sarcasm, Diddy. Something I'm fluent in. So anyway, to the shelter of the now freed portrait ghosts. Ghosts whom Egad had previously captured and contained in paintings with a device dubbed the Ghost Portrificationizer. Just like how the Ghostbusters put the ghosts in those trap thingies. I didn't think the 2016 Ghostbusters ever did that, did they? I only saw 2016 Ghostbusters once, so I have a very fuzzy memory of that. Right. So anyway, they sent Luigi the supplied photo and a map to lure him into a trap. Gad also tells Luigi that he recently saw someone wearing a red cap go into the mansion, but has not seen him since. Upon learning that the red cap man is Mario, Egad allows Luigi to take over his duties of ghost catching, and entrusts him with his powerful vacuum cleaner, the Poltergust 3000. And a multi-purpose invention called the Game Boy Horror that allows him to communicate with Luigi. The Game Boy Horror sounds like something that I would invent, but my vision of it would just stream movies like Get Out, or Psycho, or Quiet Place, or The Conjuring, or Annabelle, or Saw, or The Nun, or The New Mutants, or IT!
Please let me get up this time!
We all float in Luigi's Mansion, Georgie! Sonic, you probably shouldn't have done your Pennywise voice. Otherwise, she would be moving around when she's not supposed to. Sorry, Sonic.
Sonic, come here. I forgive you, Sonic. It's okay. You didn't know.
Maybe it was a bad idea for me to be here.
Who's gonna talk to him? I can't because I can't get up.
Fine. I'll let you get up just this once.
Give me the wheelchair, Sonic. I'm not risking anything.
It's gonna be fine. Trust me. Now go talk to him.
Sonic... I can't run, you know.
Sonic couldn't have gone too far. Just walk slowly until you see him.
Okay. When Sonic said couldn't have gone too far, I didn't know you were right here, Sonic.
What do you want, Gene?
I wanted to cheer you up, Sonic. I might need a little help getting sat down, Sonic.
Why should I help you? I hurt you. You guys are better off doing this review without me.
Sonic, you and Sonic were the ones who inspired me to do these reviews. I want you to be there with us, please, Sonic. You're one of my brothers. You and Sonic took me in after my mom died after I graduated from college.
If I hadn't done that voice, I wouldn't have put you in danger.
Sonic, it's okay. I'm fine now.
Are you sure about that?
I'm sure, Sonic. Trust me.
What am I supposed to do now? I've gone through absolute hell since the Dark Brotherhood took over, and nothing's getting better.
I lost both of my parents because of them, but at least the Dark Brotherhood is gone.
But when I tried to make a joke with you, I ended up hurting you. I should know better than to scare you with my Pennywise impression.
Sonic, it's just Sonic is protective when I'm pregnant, okay? You can still tease me with that.
He obviously doesn't want me around
Sonic! Come here!
What is it, Gene? Are you doing okay, Sonic? You look upset.
Do you want Sonic around, Sonic? Because he thinks you don't.
Of course I do. Now I want Gene to do my fucking Pennywise voice.
Sonic, can you explain that to him, please?
I just didn't want Gene to get herself hurt. But I did something wrong. Something unforgivably wrong. You were just having fun, Sonic. Praying like that should not ruin your day.
Exactly, Sonic. So please smile so we can finish up the review of Luigi's Mansion.
As long as you take a balloon with you, Georgie.
Oh my god!
There you go. Now, can one of you help me back up, please?
Oh, Jiminy Christmas, not this again.
It's just a kick, Sonic.
Okay, just making sure.
Okay, so where were we?
The game is played out over 4 stages, with players able to also access the training room and a gallery at Professor Egad's laboratory between stages. In each stage, players control Luigi as he explores the mansion's rooms and hunts down the ghosts that lay within them, acquiring keys to get through locked doors and eventually dealing with a boss ghost hidden at the end of the stage, with more rooms becoming accessible as each stage is completed. I just love the sound it makes when Luigi collects a key. I just think it sounds cute! Oh, if only they played that in Ready Player One. But anywho, to assist him in his task, Luigi uses a flashlight and 2 inventions supplied by Egad, the Poltergust 3000, a specially modified high-powered vacuum cleaner which also acts as a proton pack in Ghostbusters, and the Game Boy Horror, a parody of the Game Boy Color. Thankfully, it then crossed the streams with the Poltergust 3000. In order to capture Geish, Luigi must first use his flashlight to light up the Geish and stun it, revealing their heart. When this happens, players use the Poltergust 3000 to suck them up, steadily reducing the Geish hit points to 0. The more hit points, the more time it takes for a Geish to be captured, giving them a chance to break free while leaving Luigi more exposed to being harmed. If his HP is reduced to 0 from being hurt by the ghosts, the game is over. So this is one of the only Mario games that uses hearts as health. The others being Super Mario 64, Super Mario Sunshine, Super Mario Galaxy, Super Mario Galaxy 2, and Super Mario Odyssey. Once a ghost HP is reduced to 0, they are captured. Some ghosts cannot be captured easily until Luigi locates 3 special medallions, each granting the Poltergust with the ability to suck up certain elements from the rooms, and use them to capture special ghosts lying within the mansion. In addition to capturing the regular ghosts in the mansion, Luigi must also draw out special portrait ghosts from some rooms, each requiring a condition be met to make them available for capture. Once all the ghosts in a room are captured, it brightens up. The music also changes, being pleasantly whistled by Luigi, or being haunted and spooky when filled with ghosts, with Luigi humming nervously to the tune. Thanks for that, the Sonic!
Utilizing the Game Boy Horror, players can access a map of the mansion, seeing which rooms they have visited, what doors are open, and which remain locked. When Luigi finds a key during his exploration, the Game Boy Horror automatically indicates which door it unlocks, just so you don't get confused and you use it on the wrong door. The game is nice enough to let you know which door it actually unlocks. In addition to a map function, the device also keeps track of any treasure that Luigi has found. Rooms will usually have treasure hidden within, which can be either coins, gems, gold bars, paper money, and so forth. Hidden within items, and even in a chest that appears when the ghosts are cleared out, which Luigi can draw out and then suck up with the Poltergust. If a ghost harms Luigi, he will drop a small portion of collected treasure that he will need to recover before it disappears.
Gee, I wonder where they got that from. What the hell, Sonic? Every time you smack me for making a snarky remark, I don't lose rings. I was expecting you to drop your rings this time. Sonic, we talked about this. You can't have any of my onion rings that I bought from Sonic Drive-In.
After Luigi encounters a group of boos hiding in the mansion, the device can be used to find each one hiding in a room through a beeper sound and a flashing yellow light on the device, which turns red when Luigi is close to one. Boos can only be located in rooms that have become lit after their ghosts have been cleared out. Blues are trickier to deal with, as they can plant decoys and traps with objects they can hide in that can fool the Game Boy whore and will escape into other rooms if they can, forcing the player to chase after them.
The portrait ghosts can be found in certain rooms of the mansion, and here are the ghosts that can be found in the areas. In Area 1, there's Neville, who can be found in the study reading, which is something we hardly see Neville doing in Harry Potter. Lydia, who can be found in the master bedroom brushing your hair, and the boss of Area 1 is a baby named Chauncey, who is found in the nursery, and he gets angry on how you play with him by hitting him with a ball. At least our kids aren't like that, right, David?
Yep. Also, what the fuck kind of name is Chauncey? It's like the sound a steam train makes when it sneezes. Chauncey! 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 The portrait goes from Area 2 are the floating whirlwinders, who can be found in the ballroom, dancing around. Shivers the butler, he can be found in the hallway, but you capture him in the butler's room. Melody Pianissima, who can be found in the music room, who asks you what the melody she is playing on the piano is. She's either playing the athletic theme from Super Mario Bros. 3, or the underwater theme from the original Super Mario Bros. Mr. Lugs, who can be found in the dining room eating a lot of food. Spooky the dog, who can be found in the boneyard. And the boss of Area 2 is Bogmire, who is found in the graveyard. The portrait ghost of Area 3 are Biff Atlas, who is found in the rec room, pulling weights, all while telling Marty McFly to make like a tree and get out of here. Miss Petunia, who can be found taking a shower in the bathroom, all while Uncle Vernon and Dudley are getting pummeled by a million Hogwarts letters. Nana, who can be found in Nana's room knitting. Slim Bagshot, who can be found in the billiards room playing pool. Henry and Orville, who can be found in the twins' room, which this room is back on the second floor. Madame Clairvoya, who is found in the fortune teller room, which you get to meet her in Area 2, but you get to capture her in Area 3. And the boss of Area 3 is Boo Lossus, which is on the balcony. Let's not forget that if you want to save the game, there are three ways to save your game. The first way is to find a toad and he saves your game. The second way is to capture a Boo. The third way is after a boss fight. Also, let's not forget Mario's dropped items, which are his hat, letter, shoe, glove, and star. After you find one of the items, take it to Madame Clairvoya, and she can see what is going on with Mario. Huh, for some reason, I thought if you take Mario's hat to Madame Clairvoya, he would just take control of her because Luigi basically gave her Cappy.
You know this game came out way before Super Mario Odyssey!
I know, I just love Super Mario Odyssey way too much. Besides, I don't think Mario could actually capture ghosts with Cappy.
The best part of the game is the name of the blues. They're basically puns off of other named stuff. Also, the final area portrait ghosts are Uncle Grimley, which can be found in the wardrobe room during the blackout, the Clockwork Soldiers.
Why not a Clockwork Orange?
That movie was referenced in Conker's Bad Fur Day.
Oh, trust me, we know.
Anyway, the Clockwork Soldiers can be found in the Clockwork Room, and these guys are a pain in the butt to capture. Soupy, who can be found in the guest room, and can I just say that room is the weirdest room in the mansion. Jarvis, who can be found in the ceramic studio, and Iron Man won't be happy about this one.
It's a good thing Jarvis became the Vision, and Tony's new AI for his Iron Man suits is Friday.
Sir Weston, who can be found in cold storage, and lastly, Vincent Van Gogh, who can be found in the artist studio.
After numerous confrontations and challenges with many ghosts, portrait ghosts, boss ghosts, boos, puzzles, and locked doors, Luigi confronts King Boo, who has trapped Mario inside a painting like the portrait ghosts and hung him in a secret altar in the basement. King Boo pulls Luigi into the painting for their final battle in an arena that resembles the mansion's roof, within a fiery background, puppeteering a lifelike Bowser suit from the inside, using spiked, explosive metal balls thrown by Bowser. Luigi finds a way to blast off the suit's head and eventually vacuum and defeat King Boo, causing Bowser to collapse. Luigi returns to EGAD with Mario's painting and successfully extracts him from within using the ghost portraitizer in reverse. King Boo is turned into a painting along with the other portrait ghosts. The ending also sees the Haunted Mansion disappear, meaning that Disney World has lost an iconic attraction.
To be honest, the movie based on the Haunted Mansion with Eddie Murphy was just garbage. The only good movie based on a Disney attraction is Pirates of the Caribbean.
After which, Professor Egad uses the treasure Luigi collected on his adventure to build a new, non-haunted mansion on the site of the original mansion. The size of the house depends on how much treasure the player gathered before the end of the game, and that's Luigi's Mansion.
The game is really good for its time, and it's a perfect choice for a launch title, but the biggest complaint about the game, that it's too short. It could take a day or two to complete, just about as short as Sonic Forces.
This is unlike other Mario games in the past. It was pretty fun playing as Luigi taking up the role of a Ghostbusters, minus the Stay Puft Marshmallow Man, or Sigourney Weaver, or Bill Murray, or the 2016 cast. It's kinda short, but it's pretty fun. It's like you're playing a game of Clue, except that you're not finding out who committed the murder, using what weapon in what room, even though a lot of the rooms in Luigi's Mansion look like they could be good rooms to explore in Clue.
For a game that has Luigi as the main star instead of Mario, it's pretty good, and it shows that Luigi is more than just the Player 2 character, and that he can have his moments to shine, and Luigi's Mansion definitely made him shine. A flashlight, a ghost to bust them. I'm just gonna give it a 9 out of 10. It's a short game, but it's still fun.
Same here. Plus, I can say the same about Sonic Forces. Me too. I mean about giving it a 9 out of 10, not about Sonic Forces. 9 out of 10, good idea. I agree, 9 out of a 10.
Same here, 9 out of 10. So what should we do now?
Oh no!
The twins, Gene?
Yes!
At least it wasn't on mine and Dixie's wedding day!
Let's get her to the hospital right now. Let's get the going, guys. I'm gonna call Laurel.